If you teach fractions, you've heard about teaching fractions on a number line. Students struggle with fractions because they don't see them as numbers. They see them as magical symbols we learn about in math class. And research shows us that when we use number lines to teach fractions, we help students understand that fractions really are numbers and they behave like numbers. In this lesson today, we're going to assume students know something about unit fractions, 1/3, 1/8, and that they know something about representing fractions on a number line. And we're going to use that to represent larger fractions on a number line. Our first example will be 2/8. To do this activity, we're going to use fraction towers. We'll use an open number line that we'll mark, and then we've got a marker for doing our marking on the number line. As you distribute materials to students, think about having them work in groups so that they can hear each other's ideas and share information back and forth. And remember that you'll need to take some time to think about how you're going to manage the materials, distributing things out, talking to students about using them appropriately, and that practical side of teaching with manipulatives. My first question for students is, what's 1/8? Can you use the tools you have in front of you to represent 1/8? Some of them will do that by grabbing this 1/8 piece and saying, here it is. Guide them towards the number line and have them think about, how can I mark a whole? Because 1/8 has to be 1/8 of something. So I mark my beginning and end, my 0 and my 1, and then I can think about where's 1/8 in that set. Line up my pieces and mark my 1/8 on the number line. Once I've done that and students understand that place, that's the review part, where's 2/8? Where would that fall on the number line? Some students will take 2 1/8 pieces and use that to mark, lining it up at 0 again, while other students will take their same 1/8 piece and move it over a step and then land at the same spot. Have them think about what they've done here as they go from 1/8 to 2/8. They've moved 2 steps along their number line, or they've added 1 1/8 piece to a second 1/8 piece. You can ask them to represent that work as an addition sentence, and you'll hopefully see something like this, 1/8 plus 1/8 equals 2/8. You can have your students continue the activity with other 1/8 fractions, or they can work with a different fraction. We might think in a second example about marking 1/5. I'm going to demonstrate this model using virtual manipulatives. If you've got an interactive whiteboard in your classroom, this is a tool you can use for that. We'll have the same idea of our unit with 0 and 1. And if I want to mark 3/5, I'll take that 1/5 piece and count it along 3 times, labeling each step until I get to 3/5 as my mark. I can think about 3/5 then as 1/5 plus 1/5 plus 1/5. Your goal in this lesson is to help students see fractions as numbers, that they understand when they build 2/8, they're taking 1 1/8 piece and counting on to a second, or 3/5, 1 1/5, counting on to a second and a third. By using concrete models, we help students understand that fractions really are numbers. They have a place on the number line. We modeled it and marked it in our activity here. And they behave like numbers. 1 inch plus 1 inch is 2 inches. 1/8 plus 1/8 is 2/8. They work the same way. The activities are the same kind of model. And that helps students understand that these are just a number we write in a different way. When we write fractions, we use a couple of digits, a 2 and an 8. We use a line segment. When I write a large number, I might use a comma. When I write a decimal, I use a dot. Fractions really are a single number. They live in one place on the number line, and these kinds of materials can help students understand that.